Right, where are we? I just did a video on saturated fat and heart disease, and I would strongly recommend you to go and watch that video. I'm going to link it at the end of this video somewhere here on the screen or in the notes down below here. It really is worth having a look at. But this video is about the latest research and the five factors with the highest, what is called hazard ratio, so the highest risk factors for heart disease. In other words, a heart attack or a stroke. What are the five conditions that are going to give you the best chances, I guess best is not a bad word, the highest chances of having a really bad outcome in terms of a stroke or a heart attack. So welcome to ShapeFixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. I have had my share of heart problems, as I've said in many of my videos, and I was overweight and I had heart rhythm problems and I was supposed to have surgery, which I didn't have. And I changed my diet and I lost the weight and all my blood tests and my heart data is all really good now. I have here an article that was published in OPENHEART in the British Medical Journal in 2021, I think it was, yeah. And I'm going to link it here. I'm going to link the original article in the notes below the video so you can go and open it up and have a look and you can read it if you want more detail, if you're that way inclined. It's very scientific and quite impenetrable if you don't have a science training, but if you do, please go and download it and have a look, because what I'm saying in this video is not me, okay? It's coming from here. Hiding unhealthy heart outcomes in a low-fat diet trial. So it's talking about the world's biggest trial of low-fat diets, which was designed to show that we should be eating low-fat diets to avoid heart attack. It was the Women's Health Initiative randomized control dietary modification trial. It went on for about over 20 years, tracking people, the same people, through a 20-year period to see, and then to see how their heart conditions progressed and what outcomes they had, and looking at the statistics of heart attacks and strokes and weighing it up against the diets that they were put on, to try and prove that the so-called heart healthy diet was correct. And if you go through this paper, you can see that the data from over 20 years of testing doesn't prove at all that the so-called heart healthy, low fat, high carbohydrate diet had any effect whatsoever, except in many cases, an actual negative effect. But what it does show on page six, is a graph of the hazard ratios of the risk factors. Now, I'm going to go through them because it's really, really interesting. Fortunately, there is a solution to each one of these five, which does not necessarily involve drugs or surgery or anything. And you are going to be amazed at what turns out to not be one of the big five risk factors. You might be able to guess. It depends how many of videos like this you've actually already seen. So let's go. Number five, I'm starting at the bottom. Number five on the list of the risk factors is smoking. Cigarette smoking will increase your risk of a heart attack by almost 400%. 400%. So risk factor of 3.92. So that's close to 4. 400% increased risk of a heart attack or a stroke if you're a smoker, because of all the pollutants from the smoke that go into your bloodstream and damage your blood vessels, which then leads to the creation of scar tissue and plaque and patches and blood clots. 400%. Obesity. So a body mass index of over 30. Being obese increases your risk of a heart attack or a stroke by 430%. So slightly more than smoking. So smoking and being obese are equally risky. Of course, if you're doing both, then you can add those numbers together. Number three on the list is hypertension. Persistent high blood pressure. That's 460% increased risk of a heart attack or a stroke. So high blood pressure is very, very dangerous. Right up at over 600% increased risk is metabolic syndrome. Now that is a combination of obesity, blood pressure, fatty liver disease, insulin resistance. It's well on its way to diabetes. So if you are really overweight with high blood pressure and very unfit, you're probably, and eating a lot of carbohydrates, you probably have metabolic syndrome. You probably have fatty liver disease already. You need to go and get yourself checked because your chances of a heart attack are up by 600%. But number one on the list, the single highest risk factor at over 1,000%, over 1,000% increased risk of a heart attack is having type 2 diabetes. 90 to 95%, depending on which study you look at, of people with type 2 diabetes eventually die of a heart attack. That's what kills you when you have diabetes. It's a heart attack. So the risks of these things are insane. Now, what did I miss? What's not here? Hang on, we've got smoking 400%, obesity 430%, hypertension 460%, metabolic syndrome over 600%, diabetes 1000%. What about LDL? What about cholesterol? Oh, here we go. High LDL 38%. It's nothing. It's nothing. And yet we are overweight, we smoke, we have high blood pressure, we eat badly, we're trending towards diabetes, we're already on metformin if we're not already injecting ourselves with insulin, and we take statins to control our cholesterol. Why? Why bother? Cholesterol is not the problem. Increased LDL gives you a 38% increased chance of having a heart attack. Diabetes is 1,000%. Obesity is over 400%. This is madness. And when you take drugs to lower your cholesterol, you have horrible side effects because you need cholesterol for your brain, for your cell membranes, for your nervous system. So lowering your cholesterol, even if you think you're reducing your risk of heart attack, which is so insignificant compared to obesity and smoking and all those other things, gives you horrible side effects. Brain fog, confusion, forgetfulness, fatigue, muscle pain, it's not worth it. Now, here's the good news. Smoking, what's the solution to smoking? Oh, hang on, don't smoke. Right, moving on. I'm not even getting into that. Everybody knows they shouldn't smoke. It's not lung cancer, it's not the big problem. It is a problem, but heart attack is a problem. What about the others? How do you sort out obesity? How do you get your blood pressure down? How do you resolve your metabolic syndrome, and how do you put yourself in remission and get out of type 2 diabetes? If you have type 2 diabetes and you're on medication, those medications are going to keep you diabetic, just hopefully keep you alive for longer. But your quality of life is miserable and you're not going to be cured. Can you be cured? Yes. What you can do for all four of those things, for obesity, for blood pressure, for metabolic syndrome, and for diabetes, is go on a low carbohydrate diet. A high fat diet, and I say again, watch my video about saturated fat and see what the American College of Cardiology says about saturated fat. It's good for you. Go on a low carbohydrate ketogenic diet of any description you like. I don't care if it's a vegan version or a carnivore version. This is urgent and you need an intervention. Now, I would say if you have any of these issues, do it for 3 months. Go on a low carbohydrate diet. Just cut sugar out of your diet and understand that sugar is carbohydrates. Don't eat them. Eat fat. Eat more fat. Convert your body from a sugar burner to a fat burner. It's a much cleaner fuel. Your weight will come down. Your blood pressure will come down. Your insulin resistance will resolve and you will become more insulin sensitive, which will then release the fat on your liver and you will resolve your fatty liver disease and your blood sugar will remain stable because you are not eating any sugar and you're not spiking your insulin up and down, and you don't need to keep taking drugs to keep the sugar at a level that it shouldn't be at. It should be down here at a base level and it would be constant. Try it. Just try it. Thousands of people are now doing this. You go on a low sugar diet. Diabetes is glucose intolerance. So why are you eating glucose? Because your doctor says eat glucose, eat carbohydrates 5 times a day. That's insane. That's like telling an alcoholic to have 3 whiskeys a day. That's not how you fix it. You don't fix a disease by prescribing the very substance that has caused the disease in the first place. Okay? Heart disease is not about cholesterol and is not about dietary fat. Go check my other video. See what the College of Cardiology says about heart disease and fat. Heart disease is caused by carbohydrates and too much sugar, which makes you fat, raises your blood pressure, gives you fatty liver disease, and leads to diabetes. Oh, and smoking, but I don't think we need to go there. Thank you for watching. Please watch the other video. Please subscribe to the channel. Consider becoming a member of the channel so that you get to share in our weekly member videos where I address sort of topics of the day. And go and check out our channel, our webpage, www.shapefixer.com. There's more information there. And I've got videos there in playlists, so it's easier to navigate them. Trying to find them on YouTube, we've got over 200 videos. It might be difficult. Hopefully we'll see more of you. Thank you for your time.